In this vlog, we are going to see the implementation of deep linking concept in your Flutter application. So we are using tool called OneSignal for this purpose. So in our previous tutorial, we have seen the deep linking concept using Firebase. And now we will optimize the way we use this particular Firebase in our application for deep linking. So with the help of the OneSignal, it will be very much easy for even a beginner to get started with this particular deep linking concept. So now let us start with configuring OneSignal first, and then we will be trying to make our Firebase project accessible by the OneSignal so that we can easily send messages to our Flutter application. These messages are nothing but of deep linking. So with the help of these particular messages, we will be implementing deep linking concept in our Flutter application. So the very first thing we need to do is we need to create a new app in our OneSignal dashboard here. So this is my OneSignal account, and here you can see I have implemented OneSignal on my websites as well here. So even my websites will get push notification based on OneSignal. And these are the two applications which I have made for Flutter. So this is the latest application which I have made to show you, to demonstrate you the implementation of Flutter deep linking concept. I just want to show you how to create a new app if you are a beginner. So here, tap on the new app here, and first of all you need to select the name of your application here. So I'm going to select Flutter, OneSignal, or just specify your application name over here. And below this, you are having these options, you need to select a platform. So if you are trying to implement deep linking concept for your iOS application, then select the first option here. And if you want to implement for Android application, then this one, and accordingly please select your platform here. So even you have more options, for desktop, if you are trying to create applications, then you can go for these options, and this one is for Chrome. And depending upon your requirement, try to select the options available here. And now I'm trying to select Google Android here. Currently my Xcode is getting updated, so I'm trying to add OneSignal deep linking to my Android application. So here we will be selecting Android, and going forward we will be selecting Flutter here. And before selecting Flutter as our platform, after providing our server key and sender ID, it will be asking us the cross platforms as well. So React Native, Flutter, and all these things. So here we need to have Firebase server key and Firebase sender ID. So from where we get these two things is in our Firebase console, we need to create a project here. So I already have a project deep link here. And if you are not having project, just try to tap on the new project, or just go through our previous tutorial link I am providing here. There I have explained you how to create a project in Firebase. So now tap on the settings button here on the project overview, and tap on project settings here. So here under cloud messaging, you have this server key and sender ID. So let's try to copy these two things now and add to our OneSignal console here. So these two things are the main here. With the help of these two things, we are able to send a message to our Android or iOS application, and from there we can implement the deep linking concept. And also it's the same way when you are trying to implement push notifications. So here in this particular tutorial, I have discussed on implementation of push notification in our Flutter application. So here I'm providing the link in the description section below. You can just go through it and tap on save and continue here. And now, as I have said earlier, we have an option of selecting the platform now. Yes, previously we have selected Android here, and now based on Android, what particular platform you are trying to implement your project. Are you implementing on native Android platform or React Native, Unity, all these options. So we are selecting Flutter here, So if you select iOS in the first level, you will be also provided with these particular options. So don't get confused. And now let's tap on save and continue here. And the first step is like installing the SDK. So if we come back to our Android Studio here, under the pubspec file, I have already added the dependency for OneSignal here. So make sure you add this particular dependency and also try to provide the latest version available every time. And now let's tap on pubget here. And let's start with our coding part now. So the very first import we do in our Flutter applications is like material.dart, and the next one is like we need to import OneSignal here. Void main run app, and inside which let us try to specify my app, and for which we are going to create a class now. So I'm just going to consider a stateless widget, or let's try to consider a stateful widget here itself. So just we are going to declare a single class, and here let us try to name it like my app. So inside the my app here, we are going to add an init state here. Why I have chosen stateful widget is like we can perform some actions here, but for this particular tutorial, I'm just going to explain you the configuration part and the usage of deep linking concept in our Flutter application. So from the coming tutorials, we are going to see more features like how to implement a deep link within our application. That is like we need to move from one screen to another. So that is like whenever we get a deep link message here, when tapping on that particular message, we will be directed to a particular screen in our application. Okay, so now let's start with adding the app ID and also setting the log level for our project. So onesignal.share.setLogLevel here. And now here you have again two options like log level and visual level. So for the log level, I'm going to set it to debug here, and you are having all these options. Just set these options according to your requirement. And the second one, I currently don't require this option, so I'm just turning off it. OS log level dot none. Okay. And the next thing is we want to add our app ID here so that our app gets detected. So set app ID here, and from where we get this particular app ID. Okay. Let's get back to our Firebase console here. So this is our app ID. Just copy this particular app ID and tap on done here. And you can see the steps here on the right hand side. So tap on the done here. And once you enter into the console also, you can get the app ID from here under the settings. So keys and IDs. So when you tap here, you will be getting this particular OneSignal app ID. So if you miss collecting your app ID from the first screen, then you can even collect from here as well. So let's try to add the app ID, and yes, that's it. The configuration part on our application is completed. So I'm just trying to run an emulator here and will try to show you the output now. So let's try to run this particular app, and here you can see we have nothing much specified here. So just to have a minimum application view, I'm just going to specify scaffold here, and inside which let us specify an app bar, and with the help of a text widget, let us try to specify OneSignal deep link. Okay, so let us try to open our emulator here. Yes, we have got OneSignal deep link. The application is installed now, and let us try to send a deep link message here. And also, before sending a deep linking message, let's try to see in the console whether our device is detected on OneSignal or not. So just now we have added an app ID and also the required settings on our application, right? So let's try to see under the audience here. Here you can see I have just added this particular, we have just run our application on emulator, right? So it is detected in our console here. And now let's move to the messages here and tap on new message. And now let's try to send a message here. So the message is like one signal deep link. I'm trying to add here. So this is just a sample. Okay. And the next thing is like we are going to add an image here. So here I've just uploaded a logo of mine in IMGBB here. So I'm just going to use the same logo. And launch URL I'm trying to specify my website here. So what we are trying to do is whenever we get a message on our device and when you tap on that particular message, in general if it is a push notification we will be opening up our application so that the user can go through our app. But here this is a deep link, so we can perform two ways here. It's like we can open an external website in our browser, or we can open our application and redirect to a particular screen where we want the user to be. So here in the first tutorial I'm showing you how to open a website in our browser. So here I've just added a launch URL and an image and a message over here and title. And also there are other platform settings here. You can just make sure you add these details when they are required. And also advanced settings are there. And if you are having any queries in these two options, just let me know in the comment section below. And also you can schedule this particular message. It's not like you need to send immediately every time. You can specify a time. And also these options like intelligent delivery and custom time per user time zone, all these options you can just customize them accordingly. And so I have added all the required details, and you have also an option to test it. So in coming tutorials we will be seeing these two options here. And let's tap on review and send. And here it is showing us all the details which we have provided. If they are correct, you can just tap on send message, and if there are any changes you can make the changes. So why these many reviews are provided here? Because whenever you tap on send message in real time scenario, the messages will be going to thousands of and lakhs of devices sometimes. So it's better to recheck every time. Okay. And let's tap on send message and go to our emulator here. Here you can observe the bell icon. So we have got a notification. So this is the notification which we have got, and here you can see we have not got an image. So let's try to see why we have not got an image, and let's tap on this particular option now. And it is asking you to accept this basic things because we have created an emulator, so it's like a Chrome browser option. And here you can see our website is now open on our emulator. So this is how a basic deep linking concept is being explained. If you want to send a message again, just tap on duplicate here. So yes, this is it for this tutorial on Flutter deep linking concept. And in our next tutorials, we are going to see how to implement a deep link such that we move to a specific screen on our Flutter application. And also here are our previous tutorials where we have discussed Flutter Firebase deep linking concept. So you can just go through these particular concept as well if you are interested. And the links for this tutorial I am providing in the description section below. And also in this particular tutorial we have discussed about Flutter one signal push notification. So how we can send a push notification. It's again a similar concept like how we send a message over here. So you can just go through this tutorial as well. And for more interesting tutorials, do like, share and subscribe to our channel.